Hello again, and welcome to the latest bulletin from Haverhill UK News, brought to you by Haverhill TV. In the news for today, Friday, July the 26th, thieves after copper have cut dangerous gas pipes outside a series of homes in Haverhill and left them hanging. Town's largest housing provider has received a national award recognising its resident involvement service. And a Haverhill community who originated in southern India have brought the colour of their culture to a special fundraiser. Police have issued a warning after a series of incidents where exterior gas pipes were cut by thieves attempting to steal piping. Haverhill police are appealing for information after a gas pipe was cut and left hanging at the side of a home in Elmhurst Close between 10:30 p.m. on Monday and 7:30 the next morning. There appear to have been three similar incidents in the Haverhill area overnight on Monday to Tuesday, with gas pipes cut or broken outside properties in Kirtling Place and Hamlet Road, as well as the Elmhurst Close incident. Police are warning of the dangers of tampering with gas pipes and the subsequent risk of leaks. They warn that if people are unaware that gas pipes have been tampered with, there is a risk of flames going near what could potentially be leaking gas pipes. If you have seen anything suspicious in the area or have any information relating to these crimes, please contact PC Sharon Coe at Beresford Edmonds on 101 or Crime Stoppers anonymously on 0800 555 111. And police are also appealing for information after all four tyres on a blue hatchback was discovered flat after it was parked on Castle Avenue in Haverhill. They say the damage is believed to have been caused by a sharp object. The incident took place between 2 p.m. on Sunday and 8:30 a.m. on Monday, and if you have any information relating to this event, please contact PC Adam Fayers at Beresford Edmonds on 101 or Crime Stoppers anonymously on 0800 555 111. And a thief got into a house in Shadowbush Close via a rear patio door sometime between midnight and 5:30 a.m. on Wednesday and stole a handbag and its contents and an Apple iPad. If you were in the area and noticed any suspicious activity, you're asked to call PC Gary McCormack at Beresford Edmonds Police on 101 or Crime Stoppers on 0800 555 111. Haverhill's largest social housing provider, Haverbury Housing Partnership, has been recognised and praised for its exemplary resident involvement service. Haverbury has been awarded the Resident Involvement Quality Standard by the Tenant Participation Advisory Service, or TPAS, a national organisation working to promote tenant empowerment. It's the second time that Haverbury has been granted the prestigious accreditation, after being one of the first in the East of England to be accredited in 2010 for resident involvement. This accreditation is awarded to landlords who excel in involving residents and tenants in service development, delivery and improvement. Sandra Norris, a tenant board director and chairman of Tenants Forum at Haverbury, was presented with a plaque by Michelle Reed, the chief executive of TPAS, who congratulated Haverbury on its achievement, particularly the strong sense of respect between employees and residents. As part of the accreditation process, TPAS looked thoroughly at every aspect of Haverbury's work with its tenants and spent 3 days on site carrying out interviews, focus groups and observations before the award was made. And finally, Haverhill has many new communities of people from all parts of the world nowadays, and one thing many of them have in common is their membership of the Roman Catholic Church. One such group, who come from southern India, have held a traditional feast for their fellow worshippers. St. Felix Catholic Church parishioners, originally from Kerala, organised an evening of music and dance from their homeland, serving up a feast of their delicious food and entertainment to a packed St. Felix school hall. Margaret Stewart, acting head of St. Felix School, which is attended by a number of the younger performers, and Father Michael Teeder, the parish priest, lit the Nila Vilaku, a traditional lamp, at the beginning of the celebrations. The programme of dance was performed by men, women and children, all dressed in traditional costumes for the dances that included the traditional Bharatanatyam, as well as folk dances and Bollywood dance routines. Many of the families prepared and served their food to an appreciative audience. The evening was an event organised by the Keralan community, led by Jose Valiathazath, and is part of the calendar of fundraising activities to repay the £150,000 loan incurred from building the new St. Felix Church at Princes Way. That's all for today, but join us again on Tuesday. And meantime, keep in touch by going to www.haverhill-uk.co.uk or following us on Twitter. And don't forget my weekly Heart of the Matter video blog tomorrow. Meanwhile, here's the weekend weather.